Good morning, and welcome to Our Lady of Mount Carmel Church. Here are some announcements. This month's Eucharistic Adoration Hour is this Tuesday, June 11th, from 6:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. at St. Paul's the Apostle Church. Please join us and enjoy the silence in God's presence. Advanced tickets are now available in the vestibule for the Mount Carmel Pasta Dinner on June 22nd. Please stop by after Mass for your ticket. Kindness Matters is the 2024 Evangelization Initiative of the Diocese of Albany. We will utilize lawn signs to encourage people to step up and be kinder to one another. We have lawn signs available for you at the entrances of the church. Please take one today after Mass. Today's Mass is applied for the repose of these souls: Bruna Grasso, Yolanda Crosby family, John Patascio and Sabina Chicaretta, Mary and Evan DiMatteo, Schwenk family, Angelo Meza, Tony Antonucci, Anthony Moriello, Deanna Bove, Jean Quantone, Mary Capasso, Irene and James Kelly, Dorothy and Chet Morrow, Jean LaSorsa, Jane Sirocco, Rosalie Clossy, Gary Konecki, Jonathan Mills, Barbara Crystal, Bradley Crystal, Alicia DeMarco, Vilma Marone, Paul Badowski, Joseph Campanella, Josephine Palmarino, Barbara Coughlin, John and Helen Mack Simic, Barbara Bennett, Ann Sturgis, Edward Doris and Michael Kubik, Nancy Heath, Allison Walsh Sardinian, David Brennan Sr., Daniel Brennan Sr., Frank Brueger Jr., Mary Hogman, Dolores Rever, Luis Azoya, Kevork Sal Mastali. Our Mass will begin momentarily. Once again, welcome.
At the sound of our name, we are the young, our lives are a mystery. We are the old who yearn for your face. We have been sung throughout all of history, called to be light to the whole human race. So lowly, give us the courage to enter the song. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call on you in our need may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. After the man, Adam, had eaten of the tree, the Lord God called to the man and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked?" "You have eaten then, from the tree of which I had forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put there with me, she gave me the fruit from the tree, and so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly you shall crawl, and the dirt you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head while you strike at his heel." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
the Lord, there is mercy and the fullness of redemption.
Second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, I believed and therefore I spoke, we too believe and therefore we speak, knowing that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything is indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this momentary light affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we now look to what is seen, but is producing for us eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen. For what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. For we know that our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. The word of God.
Thanks be to God. From the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus came home with his disciples. Again, the crowd gathered, making it impossible for them even to eat. When his relatives heard of this, they set out to seize him, for they said, "He is out of his mind." The scribes who had come from Jerusalem said, "He is possessed by Beelzebul, and by the prince of demons he drives out demons." Summoning them, he began to speak to them in parables. How can Satan drive out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand. That is the end of him. But no one can enter a strong man's house to plunder his property unless he first ties up the strong man. Then he can plunder the house. Amen, I say to you, all sins and all blasphemies that people utter will be forgiven them. But whoever blasphemes against the Holy Spirit will never have forgiveness, but is guilty of an everlasting sin. For they had said, he has an unclean spirit. His mother and his brothers arrived. Standing outside, they sent word to him and called him. A crowd seated around him told him, your mother and your brothers and your sisters are outside asking for you. But he said to them in reply, who are my mother and my brothers? And looking around at those seated in the circle, he said, here are my mother and my brothers. For whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Through the words of the Gospel, may our sins be wiped away. I wish to share with you news of a very difficult experience I've had over the past few weeks. Maybe in your world, not so difficult, but in mine, a bit. And it involves automobiles. As you know, I have 5 ministries in the Diocese of Albany, pastor of 3 parishes, and also judge and judicial vicar of the Diocese of Albany at the tribunal. So I have to divide my time very carefully between Albany and Schenectady. 13 years ago, 5 priests did what I am doing today. Just to give a little glimpse, of course, it's not precisely a 20% division equally to everyone, but you get the picture. But it involves a lot of driving. And from time to time, for the diocese, I am on the road at other dioceses or pastoral centers in the state. And the last day that my car ran correctly was Wednesday, May 22nd. I traveled to Syracuse and back. The car ran like a top. I have a 2011 Buick Lucerne. It has 111,700 miles. It's seen its day, but I love it. As you know, the car makers are making fewer and fewer sedans and cars. Now we're moving to SUVs, big trucks, and big money for those cars. I like regular sedans. I want to keep that car on the road as long as possible. Well, everything was going great. I came home from Syracuse on May 22nd. On Thursday, May 23rd, you know I live at St. Paul's Rectory on Albany Street, I start the car up and the car starts. Great. And I'm getting ready to go to Albany, to the pastoral center, to the tribunal. I put the car into drive. I step on the gas pedal and nothing happens. I said, oh, we have a problem. So then I stepped on it again, and then it did move, but this time it made an abrupt shift, like pushing me up in the car. I said, uh-oh, something is out of whack here with the vehicle. And then it finally got on the road, but not above 30 miles an hour. You should have seen the people's expressions with their hands on Central Avenue going up to the Albany Pastoral Center. Get this man out of here. So I'm going 30, but above 30, it was knocking and making all kind of abrupt movements. So I finally, on the way back of my long journey to Albany and back, I stopped at my mechanic and I said, can you take a look at this? Something is wrong here. All of a sudden, I'm having these problems. I never had anything like this in my whole life. He said, there's nothing wrong with the engine. Your problem is the transmission. Oh boy. So he said, you need to go to this place and have the transmission looked at because I don't deal with that. There's only a very few people that deal with transmission. Now I know you wouldn't believe me, so I brought the receipt. I got my car out of surgery on Monday, June the 4th. I have never paid a single expense except for a down payment on a car. Here we go, $4,569 for a new transmission. All of a sudden, it went shot. Amazing. But I say to the Lord, dear Lord, this has to happen right now. I have to pay on my diocesan appeal by June 30th. How am I going to pay this? And everything that comes with all the bills in life. What is going on, Lord? What did I do to deserve this? I say in jest. Of course, I don't mean that, because there are many of our Catholic brothers and sisters who believe that the problems we have to endure in life are curses from the Lord, and that the timing couldn't be worse, and it's our fault, that it's because of our sins of the past, that somehow, right now, in the month of June 2024, we now have this cross to bear from God. And this way of thinking is very difficult and pernicious for the soul, because the soul thrives for a union with Heavenly Father, not based on some kind of transaction. Well, we think something in life went bad, and now we're going to blame the Lord because the chips did not fall in our favor on our own schedules the way we wanted them to. I didn't tell you, but that car ran very well and with very few repairs over the life of that car. And I hope for another 100,000 miles for the transmission warranty they gave me for that price, right? But I don't tell you the entire picture, so that there are crosses that you and I have to bear. But the whole picture is that we have received many blessings at the same time as we have been given the crosses to bear. Rather than condemn the Lord for some sins, I would like to share with you the wisdom of St. Faustina Kowalska. Of course, we know her from her vision of our Lord in Divine Mercy. Jesus, I trust in you. And I select her teaching to share with you on this day because this is not a saint from 15 centuries ago, but as one who told us in 1936 this wisdom, quote, I have understood that at certain and most difficult moments of my life, I shall be alone, deserted by everyone, and that I must face all the storms and fight with all the strength of my soul, even with those from whom I expected to get help. But I am not alone, because Jesus is with me, and with him I fear nothing. I am well aware of everything, and I know what God is demanding of me: suffering, contempt, ridicule, persecution, and humiliation will be my constant lot. I know no other way, for sincere love, ingratitude, but this is my path, marked out by the footprints of Jesus, my strength and my only hope. In you alone is all my hope. Of course, dear family, transmissions are only the smallest part of the challenges and crosses that we will ever have to bear as God's people. Very small. Some crosses are more intense. Relationship problems, a diagnosis that we don't want to hear from our doctors, or a struggle along the way. How do we bear with these burdens? We do so like the saints. We welcome them and know that the Lord is near, not far away. We heard today from God's word the beginning of the entry of sin into the world. Sin entered the world when our ancestors rejected the Lord and his commands, and by eating from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, introduced the way that they wanted to be not just like God, but they wanted to be over the Lord. And that's the whole introduction of sin into the world. And that our Lord overturns that sin by the power of his death and resurrection. And when Jesus teaches us that the way of the Holy Spirit is to reject the evil and to get away from Satan, people think he is mad or that he has gone crazy and that Satan must now be in him. But that is not the case. God, the Holy Spirit, whom we can never reject, is the way of removing evil from our lives and removing a way of condemning God. Because we can all condemn the Lord for something that went wrong in our lives or something that is going wrong and not the way that we want. But the path of the saints will be to embrace the way of the Lord, which includes the cross. No matter how hard we try to avoid the cross, we will all have to bear that, and we bear that with joy. Did you hear carefully St. Paul's lesson about the building of God? It is not a building such as we have here in the church with four walls, but it is a building made in heaven, really made with our prayers, our pleas, our petitions before Heavenly Father. And to this building of heaven, we wish to ascend one day when we fall asleep and judged and found worthy of life and eternal communion with Heavenly Father. I am always in awe when looking around in our assembly, brothers and sisters of one family, not based by last name, but one family in Him. And let us admit it, for some of us, this may be our last Mass together. Next week, we find someone is ill, a little under the weather. Next week, we see they're also not here, a second or third week. And then we find that someone has really fallen ill, and then they may fall asleep in the Lord. We do not know when our last Mass is. These are sacred words that we hear, that we have an eternal dwelling as one family. Here we are today, June 9th, 2024. But we don't know about next Sunday or even tomorrow what God will have in store for us. But we will face any obstacle or burden, like the saints, with joy. And as one family, taking each day as a precious gift from God, not an opportunity to condemn the Lord for what went wrong or what we wanted our way and didn't get, but rather to accept whatever the will of God is and to see that the Lord has revealed for us, even in the crosses, a real path of discipleship in Him, not to see us versus them, but one family as brothers and sisters who do the will of God and who try to put it into practice day by day. And this is the transmission from our Lord that He wishes to share with us His life, His words, His tradition, His church, and by this we can truly be saved. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate, He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us continue to pray for our family.
For the church, that with the help of God and the Holy Spirit, we may better discern the Lord's will and follow it sincerely, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have no home, for those who are unsafe or unstable, that they may experience the Lord's mercy, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students who have graduated or are graduating, that they may never lose the joy of learning through the intercession of St. Thomas Aquinas, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the benefactors of our parish, living and deceased, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have fallen asleep in the Lord, especially those for whom this Mass is applied, that they may experience the eternal rest of Christ Jesus in the banquet of heaven, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. We ask all of these prayers through Christ our Lord.
As you present our gifts, please join in singing number 387, The Summons, 387.
Receive the bread we offer you, the fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. It will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite hearts, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. And may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Dear brothers and sisters, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer may be an acceptable oblation to you, and lead us to grow in charity. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven,
we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Edward Scharfenberger, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercies we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace, everyone. Peace be with you. Welcome back. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
I will pray.
body of Christ.
Give them hearts for love.
The body of Christ.
I will speak the body my of word Christ. To them.
The body of
Shall
Christ.
Let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil and lead us to do what is right. Through Christ, our Lord. Have a wonderful week ahead, everyone. Take good care. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Our recessional song is number 447. How can I keep from singing? 447.
Through all the tumult and the strife, I hear that music ringing. It sounds and echoes in my soul. How can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm. While to that rock I'm clinging.
Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? But though the tempest round me roar, I hear the truth that liveth.
What though the darkness round me close, songs in the night it giveth. To that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing?
Hello, everyone. Happy Sunday. How are you? Good to see you. You have a great week. Bye-bye, Madeline. Farewell. Peace be with you. Take care.